Hello, my dear students. Today, we were going to learn the chapter 4, that is atomic structure, from your chemistry book. In this chapter, we were going to introduce the atom, the molecule, the radical, and also the basic structure of an atom. So let's start. In the first slide of this presentation, we were going to learn the definition of an atom and also the basic structure of an atom. So what is an atom? Basically, it is the basic unit of matter and also the smallest particle of an element which is not capable of independent existence. An element is made up of only one kind of atoms, and the properties of an element depend upon the atoms constituting it. Now we are coming to the basic structure of an atom. Atoms are built up of subatomic particles, that is protons, neutrons and electrons. Nucleus in the center of an atom contains protons and neutrons, and protons and neutrons are together called nucleons. That is situated in the center of the atomic nucleus. Orbits, that are the imaginary paths in which electrons revolved around the nucleus. You all know that protons are the positively charged particles, electrons has a negative charge, and neutron has no charge. That means neutral is neutral. Now we are coming to the part of modern periodic table. In 1869, Mendeleev classified elements systematically in a table called modern periodic table. In the modern periodic table, atoms of all elements are arranged according to their increasing order of atomic numbers. So, what is the atomic number? Atomic number is basically the number of protons present in an atom. And also you can see the number of electrons, as the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons. Now we are coming to the atomic mass of an atom. So what is an atomic mass, or the mass number of an atom? That is basically the total number of protons and neutrons. So the number of protons and neutrons present in an atom together are called the mass number of that particular atom. Now we are going to discuss about the brief history of discovery of an atom. In 1897, Sir J.J. Thomson discovered electrons. He studied the structure of the atom and concluded that atoms are divisible and contained negatively charged particles, which were called electrons. In 1898, Goldstein discovered the protons. He studied the structure of the atoms and concluded that since all atoms are electrically neutral, there must be residual positively charged particles in them, which were called protons. In 1911, scientist Rutherford studied the atomic model and concluded that atoms form a space with a centrally located nucleus and the positive charge is in the central nucleus. Electrons are seen to revolve around the nucleus. So, by that, he discovered the atomic nucleus. In the year of 1932, James Chadwick discovered the neutrons. He studied the atomic model and concluded that in the nucleus of the atom are present particles which have no charge but mass almost equal to the mass of the proton. This led to the discovery of neutrons. Later, the atomic structure, further studied by Bohr, led to the discovery of the modern atomic. Now we will going to explain the term molecule. A molecule is the smallest particle of a pure substance, element or compound which can exist independently and retain the physical and chemical properties of the substance. Now, what is a molecule of an element? A molecule of an element is formed from the same kind of atoms. That can be two hydrogen atom, that can be two nitrogen atom, that can be two oxygen atoms. And what is a molecule of a compound? A molecule of a compound is formed from different kind of atoms. That is, when two hydrogen atoms combined with one oxygen atom, it will make water molecule. Or when one atom of hydrogen is combined with one atom of chlorine, it will form hydrochloric acid or HCl. So that is a molecule of a compound. Now, we have to explain the term atomicity. What is atomicity? Atomicity is the number of atoms present in a molecule of an element. That can be classified into monoatomic molecule, that is a molecule of an element composed of one atom, only one atom. That is known as monoatomic molecule. For example, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. And the metals, that is potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium, iron, copper. Now, diatomic molecule. A molecule of an element composed of two atoms is known as diatomic molecule. For example, elementary gases, that is hydrogen, oxygen, chlorine, nitrogen. Now, triatomic molecule. A molecule of an element composed of three atoms is known as triatomic molecule. An example of that is ozone. Polyatomic molecule. A molecule of an element composed of more than three atoms is known as polyatomic molecule. And the examples are phosphorus, that is tetraatomic, that means the number of atoms present in it is four. And sulfur, that is octaatomic, as the number of atoms present in it is eight. Now we are going to discuss the term radical. A radical is a single atom of an element or a group of atoms of different elements behaving as a single unit and with a charge on the group. A radical takes part unsplit in a chemical reaction and retains its identity in the reaction. There are two types of radicals, that is positive radicals and negative radicals. Positive radicals, basically it has the positive charge on the group, that is basically hydrogen or a metal in a chemical reaction. For example, that will be ammonium radical, that is NH4+. And the negative radical, it is a radical which behaves like a non-metal in a chemical reaction and it carries a negative charge over it. That can be carbonate radical, that can be sulfate radical or nitrate radical. A compound may be considered to have a positive part and also a negative part. The positive part is called the basic radical and the negative part is called the acid radical. So we can assume an example like sodium chloride. So here the positive part is sodium plus and the negative part is chlorine minus. So sodium plus is said to be a basic radical and chlorine minus, that is Cl minus, is said to be a acid radical. Now we are coming to the point, that is valency. What is valency? Valency of an element or radical is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine with or displace one atom of the element or radical forming a compound. So basically that is the number of hydrogen which can combine with that particular element. So here we can take an example like water. Here one atom of oxygen is combined with two atoms of hydrogen. So the valency of oxygen is 2. Another example is also given. Two atoms of hydrogen is combined with one radical of sulfate. So the valency of sulfate is 2. Some elements are also there which do not combine with hydrogen. Then the combining power of the element with an element whose valency is known, by that we can know the valency of that unknown element.